decided to do something fancy today as far as the video, and I decided that no, I just want something simple, and so this is going to be a microphone, gentle, slow touching, and slow rambling. Don't really know what I would like to talk about, but we'll figure it out as we go along. It is going to rain again in California, so we got quite a bit of rain lately. Beauty of nature all around you. The sun sometimes setting and sometimes visible from the rain clouds illuminates the sky so nicely. It's a very pleasant peaceful at times to just drive and look at the mountains. I think that every area has something unique about it, wherever you live. Could be mountains, could be any body of water, ocean, lake, sea, a river. Whatever it is, and just try to enjoy it as much as I do. At times you will hear my heater. It makes random noises, unfortunately. Not one of those newer heaters, and when it heats up it makes noises, when it cools down it makes noises, and also somewhere in between. So forgive me for that. Also here in California we have a starting up with poppies already peeking through and covering entire hills. It is still cold, so wildflowers are not yet abundant, but it's yet to come. There are a couple of places that are known for wildflowers, and one of them is Joshua Tree National Park near San Diego. I've actually never been there yet, but I'm hoping to go there this year. Another one is Antelope Valley, and Anza Borrego, but really wildflowers are found everywhere you look during the springtime, so you really don't even need to drive far to enjoy the beauty of nature. Some people unfortunately take it to another level, and they stop along the highways to take a picture of the wildflowers and rather them in the wildflowers. That causes two issues. Well, first is the fact that they're stopping along the highway, slowing down traffic, because now drivers who drive along the highway have to look what's going on. And secondly, they're trampling wildflowers. Some people even end up taking wildflowers with them. And that's not good either, just because it will deplete the amount of wildflowers for the next year. Ultimately, they will throw them away anyway, so there's really no point in taking them. But although there are so many warnings by the park authorities, people still do it. Certainly glad to be away from the truly cold weather, like so many other states experience. I haven't seen snow in 3 years. especially cleaning snow from your car. That was my worst nightmare. Although again, everything is relevant, right? One for one person's nightmare, for others it's actually a nice thing. And really, I have nothing to complain about, snow or no snow. I recently watched a documentary about Egyptians trying to escape their country. A huge variety of ASMR videos. Really, nowadays you can find on YouTube anything you might like. This choice can be quite overwhelming, in fact. You start looking for a video, thousands more come in the search box, and you wonder, where did you begin to search? But what we have is incredible resources and creators who truly care about making quality videos. We're lucky. Thing we're lucky about is living in a safe environment. Hopefully you get to enjoy safety where you are at. I know YouTube reaches millions of people, and so I hope that you are calm and safe right now. And if you're not, get to safety soon. But right this very moment, you are safe. If you can peacefully sit and watch a video on YouTube, there is some safety around you. With the seasons changing, here we can finally enjoy a little bit warmer weather in a couple of weeks soon. Soon it's coming. I don't like the cold. There's something about wearing layers of clothes. Weighs you down. It's different when you just wear something light and can go outside. And it's coming, I'm looking forward to it. They also smell very nicely. As I look outside right now, I see leaves on those trees slowly moving. Breezy right now, so the movement is very slight, sort of like almost unnoticeable, side to side, slow and gentle. Each leaf somewhat limp and as it appears, relaxed also. Not that leaves could be very stressed out either, but they just appear at peace for some reason. Some chickens outside, digging through the dirt for whatever reason. Looking for maybe worms, seeds, things like that. My neighbor does not have any roosters, just chickens. They're rather cute. I bet he has nice eggs every day. I'd love to have chickens in my backyard. One day. and brushing somebody's hair. So gentle, touching both sides of your head. Single strands of your hair. Very peaceful. Maybe it's raining outside for you too, or snowing, or maybe it's nice and bright and sunny whenever you're watching this. The change is really inevitable wherever we go, and is guaranteed. If you feel good today, that will change. If you feel bad today, that will also change. Nothing is permanent. Books. I don't remember who the author is, but it reiterates that happiness is in perspective. The author gives an example of college students at Harvard University. They really theoretically should be happy just because they end up going to this amazing institution, but quite a few of them are depressed and sad, again because of the perspective. She says, well, what he says in the book, because I don't know who the author is, I don't remember, that students who were top 1% in their class when they enter Harvard University, they become in the bottom 50%, a lot of them. And that's hard to really get used to or admit. So they focus a lot on how demanding the university is, the courses are, instead of focusing on getting the knowledge and the privilege of learning at Harvard. So, she applies the same concept to our everyday life where no matter where you are at in your life, you are in a good spot somehow. Well, I guess you could be in a worse spot regardless where you are now. So the idea is to focus on the good. And it's kind of hard to really apply this, honestly, for me. Focus on the good when it feels like there's so much bad around you. But the author says that it takes practice. So as I read along and learn a little bit more about some of these concepts, I'll try to utilize them in my life, whether or not initially they feel somewhat fake and insincere. Maybe I'll be able to trick myself into thinking that they're real, since it's all about perspective, right? Should all do the same. Look at our lives from a positive perspective, thinking about what we have versus what we don't have. Because even though social media and society in general says we need to have certain things like buy a house or a new car or have certain shoes or clothes, the truth is it doesn't really matter. It's what matters to you specifically. If those shoes really, really make you happy, and not just short term, but every day you wear them, you're happy, then heck, go for it, spend money. But if buying things, owning things, just make you happy for a minute, then what's the point, right? As the book says, happiness comes from within. Again, another concept that's a bit foreign to me, as, you know, let's face it, all of us are used to get happiness from acquiring things or doing fun things, things like that. But there's hope to restructure our thinking. I lately have become somewhat of a minimalist. Not a minimalist in per se, I have still a lot of things. But I don't just go and buy things because I'm bored. If I have an idea that I need something, I wait at least a week to buy it. I go through the thinking process, saying to myself, do you really need it? Is there any way that you can accomplish what you need to accomplish by with using this thing without it? And a lot of the times, the answer is yes. Here's an example. I want to switch to steaming food a lot more than I used to. My first impulse was to buy a steamer. So I looked on Amazon and I found a couple of steamers that I liked, and ranging anywhere from $30 to $100, and I was almost ready to purchase, and I decided, let me just add it to my wish list and think about it. And then I started searching of other ways to steam items, and I found out that you can actually do it easily in a microwave. Just add a couple of tablespoons of water, and in 3 minutes you have steamed vegetables ready. So that was my solution. An alternative would be, okay, yeah, I really want to buy a steamer, but do I really need it new? So I went to one of my local thrift shops, and out of curiosity, found at least 4 different types of steamers there that I could buy for about $6. So this is definitely an alternative if one day I'm sick and tired of steaming things in the microwave. I'll just go to a thrift shop and buy it. I'm going to utilize this type of thinking for other purchases as well, to save money and to stop acquiring things. It's kind of useful to do that. And as I go along, I try to get rid of things that I don't use. Well, I hope this wasn't an awfully boring, rambling session for you. It maybe was somewhat relaxing also. As I say goodbye to you all today, I ask that you be kind to one another. Treat your other humans, animals, creatures around you with kindness and respect. Take care of yourself and be happy.